The musical impact was immediate when we became aware of the guy called Bert Jansch.
The dexterity and the kind of where he's coming from as a stylist and then as an individual was very engaging for me.
Sitting behind the front wheel, got my woman beside me.
He had that kind of cool. He was just cool. Didn't have to try. Enviable, really.
I don't mind the drizzle and rain.
Chris said to me, I'm going to introduce you to Bert Jansch, and you'll fall in love with him because all the girls do.
Hey, baby, where's no one?
He had a poetic intensity, and he was dark and mysterious. He didn't need to bang a drum about what he did. It was all there under his fingers, you know.
The end of the 1950s, there was no fingerstyle guitar, hardly, in Britain. 10 years later, Martin Carthy, Davy Graham, Bert Jansch, they had changed the world of acoustic guitar.
Yeah, just don't bother me.
He was this painfully shy, really sweet-natured bloke, and he started to play. And I've never seen anybody attack the guitar the way he did it. He was really growling while he played sometimes.
It's like a rite of passage that guitar players should know about, a bit of knowledge. You know, you need to learn how to do this and how to do that, and at some point you're going to have to deal with Bert Jansch.
I'm glad that we're doing it here, the Festival Hall, because I think Bert liked being here. 2 years ago, we played here with Bert and the original band. The first big gig was the Festival Hall, and the last big gig was the Festival Hall.
I talked to Danny Thompson, and he said, there's only one thing that I hate about this. He said, it didn't happen when Bert was alive, so he could join in.
I think Bert would have enjoyed it. He was always quite touched when people played his songs.
I hadn't met Bernard before. His guitar strap's not quite as long as some of the guys I've worked with. But he's got it right.
I'm just gonna sort of think, hey Bert, this is for you.
We'll all be nervy, but that's okay too. Bert used to speed up when he got nervous.
Thank you.
I used to sing, just in an amateur way, with a 12-string player called Chris Ayliffe. And we were running a folk club in South London, and John Renbourn and Burr used to come down and play, and they were our highest paying artist. £8 was an awful lot in those days. But I did meet Bert, and he went, "Do you want to come and have a cup of tea, love?" I went, "Oh, all right." That was it, really. John said to me, "We're forming a band, and you're going to be the singer." First started, people gave us an awful lot of stick because we had bass and drums from the jazz world, you know, but that's, we all love jazz, but everyone used to say, "We've never heard anything like it." And I suppose really we played what we wanted to play, and we were lucky that a lot of people started to like it and bought the albums. Within that year, when we first started, we were playing the Festival Hall.
Thank you. Spencer Cousins.
Jonathan Lloyd, Jerry Conway, and Gary Foote. Thank you.
Jackson C. Frank. He made one record, which was produced by Paul Simon over here. And Bert was pretty much obsessed with that record. Jackson C. Frank had a horrible life, and a lot of people wrote songs which sound a bit like this, but, you know, they were really romantic songs about the concept of suffering. Jackson C. Frank wasn't writing about the concept of suffering. He was suffering, which I think makes this song special. Catch a boat to England, baby, maybe to Spain. Wherever I have gone, where I've been and gone, wherever I have gone, the blues, they're all the same. Send down for whiskey, baby, send down for gin. Me and room service, honey, me and room service, babe, me and room service, we'll be living a life of sin. Try another city, honey, try another town. Wherever I have gone, wherever I've been and gone, wherever I have gone, the blues, they followed me down. When I'm not drinking, mama, you're on my mind. When I'm not drinking, mama, when I'm not sleeping, baby, when I'm not drinking, you know you'll find me crying. Maybe tomorrow, honey, somewhere down the line, I'll wake up older, mama. Oh, so much older, child, I'll wake up older, and I'll soon quit all of my trying. You know, living's just a gamble, honey, loving's just the same. Wherever I have gone, wherever I've played them cards, wherever I've thrown them dice, the blues, they run the game. Catch a boat to England, baby, maybe to Spain. Wherever I have gone, wherever I've been and gone, wherever I have gone, the blues, they run the game.
Thank you very much. I had some very enlightened teachers in school, and they used to take us on school trips to see Pentangle. Now, how cool is that? And there was one particular gentleman, I have to say, who I will always remember just being completely jaw-dropped by him. I thought he was utterly astonishing, and I still think he is. Would you please welcome to the stage Danny Thompson, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to do you a song that actually my brother, who's 12 years older than me, my brother Jeff, he used to fill the house with 78s. This was in the late 50s, and so I got to hear all kinds of funky stuff. And this was on a record, and he did a nice version of it. Dwell, it's down the corner of Lonely Street on a Heartbreak Hotel. You made me so lonely, baby. You made me so lonely, baby. You made me so lonely, I could die. Well, you know it's always crowded, but you sure can't find some room. Where broken-hearted lovers do just cry away their gloom. You made me so lonely, baby. You made me so lonely, baby. You made me so lonely I could die. In black, they've been so long on Lonely Street, they ain't never coming back. I feel so lonely, baby. I get so lonely, baby. I get so lonely, I could die. So now, if your baby leaves you and you got a tale to tell, you just take a little walk down Lonely Street to a Heartbreak Hotel. You made me so lonely, baby. You made me so lonely, baby. You made me so lonely I could die. Danny Thompson.
The Cousins Folk Club in Greek Street, Les Cousins, Les Cousins. No one really knew how to pronounce it, you know. We always thought it was Les Cousins. I was looking for Les for years. Who was this bloke who owned it? In
the heart of Soho.
The first time I went down to Cousins was with John Renbaum. And we used to play there quite a lot, really.
It seemed to concentrate mostly on the young generation of songwriters, Nick Drake, Johnny Martin, Burt, John Renbaum and Roy Harper.
The Cousins was a place for guitar players. I remember Burt didn't own a guitar at one point. He had a thumb pick made out of a spoon, a silver teaspoon, which he'd sort of, he chopped the handle off and bent it round. And he was playing that, and his attack was really savage.
Just a young guy sitting in the corner in a combat jacket. Didn't look anything special. And of course, when he got up on stage, he just completely blew everyone away.
Saw lots of people there. And the all-nighters, people used to roll up in the corner with their sleeping bags.
It's daybreak, the all-nighters fade into a close. The last of the folk is rise
dozen girls.
I saw Bert one night in Les Cousins, and we all went back to Bert's flat. I just sat at his feet and tried to work out what he was doing. It was clear that he was the guy to watch. And so I learned a lot from Bert, and he was a great willing teacher. And I started writing songs about him. And this one came.
Girl ain't nothing but a willow tree, swaying in the summer breeze. You never change what has to be. Girl ain't nothing but a willow tree. Sometimes I don't know what I said till I did. I wanna be the father of your kid. Dragonfly, he sleeps till dawn. I knew I'd be here when love is gone. Crystal ball is what I wish for you. Get it straight, I love the both of you. Summer's going through a cold turkey. Girl ain't nothing but a willow tree. I give you, baby, a contact high. I love another is what I sigh. Looks like rain, I do declare. Your baby wants to take my chocolate eclair. A silken scarf, I know what a jealous trip can be. Girl ain't nothing but a willow tree. Girl ain't nothing but a willow tree. Weep for me.
With the next artist. I'll see you later. Thank you.
Oh,
I'm playing Precious Sweet Sunday Morning with Paul and Lisa. I used to play that with Bert a lot because he was so used to playing on his own. When anyone else was there, it's suddenly, oh, what's going on? With Lisa singing, it sounds beautiful. And me and Paul were trying to get her to be out of time because that's how it would have been with Bert. We're like, do you think you could just, if you edge ahead a little bit, because that's how it was with Bert.
Thank you.
Manager that we had in the late 60s, early 70s, Joe Lustig, he said we were the quietest band on stage but the loudest off. He was probably right. And then, of course, there were tours of America. It was really funny because we all went tweedy, very British, you know. I came back looking like Pocahontas with buckskin dresses and stuff. It turned out it's really going to America. We were just like children in a sweet shop, you know, all those lovely memories.
Miles from you. Thought I tried my best to be your man. Can you see, can you feel that burning in my soul? Don't you understand?
We had some fun. We had some fun on the road in those days.
We did.
Yeah. So it was real. Yeah, it was a joyful experience, which we were all mates together playing darts and socialising together, and it wasn't at all kind of like record business and publishing and like, we just did it for the music. And I think that says it all. We were all together. It's lovely.
Great.
Sorry about the speedos. That's when I could wear them.
Don't you know that your creator is running out? don't you know that your grid is running out of ideas?
Thank you very much. Thank you. Fanny, Terry, Fiona Butler.
I think it's fair to say that there are a lot of friends of Bert Jansch involved in this show this evening. I'd like to introduce somebody who's on his second album, I believe. Would you please welcome to the stage Beverly Martin and her band? Thank you.
tell you how much Bert meant to me. My favourite thing that he ever did was called Blackwater Song. And he used to play this thing for me, and I actually cried. I couldn't believe it. You know, I was going, Bert, you know.
Bert's grounding in folk music was very strong, very, very strong. I think you can hear it in his constructions of his songs as well.
When he played traditional songs, he let the words dictate where the guitar should go. That was exactly the right thing to do. But he was there first.
One morning fair, I took the down on
he had a relationship with this lovely English singer called Annie Briggs, and he learned a few songs from her. He learned Jack O'Ryan from her, and he learned Black Waterside from her.
He created something pretty wonderful out of what had been a song that had been around for 300 or 400 years, and he's come up with this exquisite arrangement, much envied, much copied, and still a benchmark for people that want to show they can play guitar and like folk music. The song I want to do is, I've called it A Kiss in the Rain to suggest something that is a bit transitory or doesn't really last. And it's a mythologizing of the handing over of Black Waterside by Anne to Bert.
In my mind I see Annie and Bert one and free over the hills but in sight of the sea. And there's no map between them, just music their guide, and the moon on dark water like a road they could ride. Now one day they wrote a new page in their lives, written on wings of seabirds as they dived, swooping down to the sea, marked the turn of the tide, and he sang in the song she called Black Waterside. Through their veins, a promise exchanged for a kiss in the rain, to return her sweet favor if she would decide to teach him the song she called Black Waterside. She sang it again and he took his guitar, and he sat by the rocks and he worked a long hour till he fitted the tune she'd agreed to provide to the words of the song she called Black Waterside. Now when it was finished and fashioned and true, becoming the bond of this oneness of two, for the words and the music you cannot divide, they're both parts of the song they call Black Waterside. Except for deception, of which there was none. There was no promise broken, no tears to be dried, to
Jenny and Bert's song was black water side. Asked him to play it to her again, for fear it might fade like a kiss in the rain. But the notes on his guitar did ripple and glide, they sparkle like moonlight on black waterside.
Thanks ever so much. Listen, it's my very great pleasure and privilege to introduce Martin Carthy and Lisa Neff.
Right, this is that black water side. I didn't really make any kind of an effort to play it like Bert. I thought it would be rather silly. Because nobody could play it like him.
One morning fair for her.
was the Irish lad I spied.
Right.
When I'm walking down the track, I got tears in my eyes. Trying to read a letter from my home. And if that train keep running right, I'll be home tomorrow night. Cause I'm 900 miles from my home. And I hate to hear my lonesome whistle blow. And I'll pawn you my watch. I'll pawn you my chain, pawn you my gold diamond ring. And if that train keep running right, I'll be home tomorrow night. Cause I'm 900 miles from my home. I hate to hear that lonesome whistle. Train keep running right, I'll be home tomorrow night. Cause I'm 900 miles from my home. I hate to hear that lonesome whistle blow. Cause I'm 900 miles from my home. I hate to hear that lonesome whistle blow.
What Bert had was a real sense of expression and looseness and darkness. What's that? That's rock and roll, it's the blues, you know. So it makes perfect sense to me that that he, of all of those guitar players of his generation, would appeal to the people that he appealed to.
Now the river sings the sweetest songs in a million harmonies, but the sun shines brighter on the other side. It's where I wanna be.
The blues side of it is intrinsic to rock music and where I've come from, my education. And so I felt really at home with that. And when I started playing like that with Bert, I realised that he really locked into that, because essentially a lot of his background is the blues.
Bert gave me permission to be eclectic. The fact that he played, on the one hand, blues, on the other hand, traditional Scots ballads. I mean, I felt very, very strongly from a very early age that all that music was essentially the same.
I don't believe I'd see a woman like you anywhere.
And when you're young and sassy and you want to get going in life and you want to express yourself, I think it was the blues that attracted us to Bert. But he was mixing the blues with the trad. That was what made him unique.
I was playing John Lee Hooker and Jimmy Reed stuff at the Town Hall in the Black Country, opening for Gene Vincent, and meanwhile I was going to a folk club on a Thursday night and playing washboard and soaking up another world alongside. I was just looking across and listening to him and getting on, wiggling around a little bit and getting ready for the leather trousers, I suppose.
Driving water from the well, spilling over on the ground. Walking home, my heart is filled with pain. Oh, it's me. Go your way, my love. Go some far land, and have you gone to lend a hand? And do you lie broken and dying now? Oh, I
spilling over on the ground. Walking home, my heart is filled with pain. Woe is me. Go your way, my love. Go your way, my love. Go. Go.
Beautiful song. Thank you. A few years ago I bumped into Bert and it was a spectacular night and very moving, beautiful guitar and I dared to knock on his dressing room door afterwards but we talked for a while and we found how many amazing roots and influences that we all share coming from these different places in music and these great cross sections and crossroads in time. In the 60s, talking of that, I used to sing a song that was immortalized by Tim Rose and I guess Grateful Dead, and later in the 90s I recorded this song, and one day there was a knock on the door and this lady stood at the door and she said, "You singing my song?" And I was totally unaware that this spectacular piece of music had been written by the great, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Bonnie Dobson. And Speedo. You can't go walking in the morning.
talk to my dog. Oh, there is no more, no, 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 no.
Bonnie Dobson. Would you give a big welcome to Ruth Jones?
This is a song from Burt's Black Swan album. And if I'm right about who the song is about, Burt sort of regrets that he didn't do more to help a fellow musician. It's from the time when Burt was living in Putney, I believe. Was there, and he did do plenty. He did as much as a man can do. It's called High Days. Didn't ask the pilot why. those high days when we used to hang around. You played your guitar, you never ever finished a song. It didn't matter then, I guess it doesn't matter now.
Way ahead of me musically. I mean, it was me, Long John Baldry, and David Graham, Martin Carthy. We thought we had it cracked, and of course Bert arrived. It was a whole new world.
We can all learn how to play scales and stuff like that, and it's the personality is the unique thing in music that everybody tries to establish, and that's something with him that is definitely unmistakable.
There had been nobody like him, and there has since that time been nobody like him.
Strolling down.
Good night.